Dear Sribash, thank you very much for your introduction. And you know, please thank much more than I deserve. And really, thank you so much. So maybe I can start my presentation because this is lunch time, and really it is very difficult to concentrate. But also it is hope. I'm hopeful. I think some noise is coming. Can some other people use this microphone? So I think because the police will be seen. Anyway, good afternoon, and I would like to my respect to all of you who are present this international webinar. I am really honored to be part of the international webinar organized by the Department of Geography, my professional engineer college, Durgapur, with the able leadership of the honorable principal, Dr. Sir. I am also honored to share the grand success. And finally, I must mention the name of Dr. Sribash Tikader. As he said rightly, I was his teacher, it's true, but at the same time, I do also acknowledge his inspiration to finish my PhD in March 9, you know. So he was waiting for me. My PhD, then you can start with Dr. Biswas. So I am thankful to Sribash on the other way also that he really helped me to finish my PhD in time. Okay, so I will give us some information. Some microphone are seen on. Slides are visible on your screen. Sribash, can you see my slides?
Yes, clear. It's clear. Yes, sir. Visible. Visible.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Okay. Yes. Now, the objective of the presentation, I already done. Sections. One is the origin and structure of the tropical cyclone, how it originates and what are the structural features of the tropical cyclone, and the nature of destruction caused by tropical cyclone, and with a special mention for Amphan, the 5-6 of the Durgapur. So I am trying to make it as brief as possible. Each time Sribash told me I can take a longer time, but don't be scared, I won't take much longer time. Okay, so coming to the definition of cyclone, IMD, that is the meteorological department, defined tropical cyclone is a rotational low pressure system in tropics when the central pressure was 5.6 millibar from the surrounding at maximum sustained wind speed. I mean, the cyclone is rotational wind, and when the rotational wind reaches the speed of 34 knots, that is 60 km per hour, it's called tropical cyclone. And it is a really, very light, say, hard and wide open, maybe ranging 150 to 800 km. make progress, you know, from a center, it start moving completely continuous within nothing, and it's from the sea, it comes to another to the landward, or towards the coast, and it, the rate of movement is 300 to 500 kilometers per day, and that is the progress. And generally speaking, not you can say that the cyclones are warm to low pressure system, having large voltage in the atmosphere, which is maintained by the release of latent heat by the convective clouds for warm pressure. It is a huge strong wind which blows around the center of the intense low pressure area. The surface of the diameter of the tropical cyclone at its surface may range up to 1000 km, and vertically it may extend up to the protoball, that is about 15 km. So that's huge. And the cyclone rotates with an axis, and the axis of shape of the axis inclined towards the colder region. So the axis rotates towards the polar region. That is another formation of cyclone. And normally in TV and other popular media like WhatsApp or Facebook, we used to see we get entertained that cyclone is coming to our land at the speed of 100 km. So it's an illusion kind of thing. It's not that. That is not the fact. So it has two phases. I can't speak because the noise in the background is irritating me. Sribash, can you mute your mouth? And so it stops. Depending on the origin. divide the inland from the land of the Bay of Biwas. So this is a map of the distribution of tropical cyclones in the equatorial region or the regions of the globe. Normally the inland region, Bay of Biwas and the Arabian Ocean, Arabian Sea, it receives about 12% of the total tropical cyclones. But in the east of Asia Coast, there is a western part of the Pacific, which is known as typhoon, and it is the highest 20%. And more interestingly, very interestingly, we can see the western coast of South America, that is the east south coast of the Atlantic or the Pacific, it does not have any tropical cyclone. So this particular ocean where we are having no tropical cyclone, and same is from the western African coast. This western African coast is also having no tropical cyclone. So that is a very interesting one, because you might be knowing that the Arctic cold current from the Arctic current, it does from this coast, so the temperature this region give up, which is the
you know, and really love that.